Well, we're going to take a moment right now to talk to Freddie Miller and find out, first of all, Freddie, where is wrestling going to be held tonight?
Glad you asked, Gordon, because tonight in Lawrenceville, at Central Gwinnett High School, a great card. Tonight in Cincinnati, Ohio, at the Cincinnati Gardens, Tommy Rich will be there. Tomorrow at 3 in Chattanooga, Tennessee. Monday in Augusta's Bell Auditorium. This coming Tuesday night in Newton, Georgia, at the high school. This coming Wednesday, Columbus, Georgia. This Thursday, a new night for Marietta. Remember, the folks who love that Cobb County Civic Center, be there Thursday night, a new night for Marietta. This Friday, Porterdale, Georgia, the Porterdale Gym. Next Sunday, May 24th, Columbus, Ohio, the Ohio Center. It'll be a sensational card. The world's champions there, Harley Race. There's a super card in Columbus, Ohio. Tickets on sale now at the Ohio Center. Monday, May 25th, Huntington, West Virginia. That's the Cabell County Memorial Fieldhouse. A great card there, Tommy Rich, a super card. And tomorrow night, Gordon, 8 o'clock, the Magnificent Omni in Atlanta. That's it.
Thank you so very much, Freddie. And talking about great competitors and all, in a couple of moments, we're going to be seeing the World Tag Team Champions in action. But first, as you know, earlier we saw Greg Valentine in action. Now we're going to hear this man's comments.
Atlanta wrestling fans, on May the 17th in the Omni, a tournament for the Georgia Heavyweight Championship, $5,000 to the winner, one of the entrants. They call him The Rock, Greg Valentine.
That's right. I haven't been in Atlanta too many times, but no tournament could be complete without a superstar like myself, a professional wrestling Greg Valentine, the Hammer. And everybody in Atlanta going to find out just why they call me the Hammer, especially when I tie up somebody's arm and crack him across the chest, and they hear it all the way down in Macon, Georgia. $5,000 to a winner plus the Georgia heavyweight title. I've been the U.S. champion. I've been one half of the world tag team champion. I've got credentials a mile long, and I also understand there's a bounty on Wildfire Tommy Rich. I don't know who's putting it up, though, but $10,000. I'll tell you what, Wildflower, I'm going to make you a wallflower. You understand what I'm talking about? $10,000 a bounty.
Well, there you have it, the comments from Greg Valentine. He was talking, of course, about it one time, co-holder of the World Tag Team Championship. Right now, we're going to take a look at the World Tag Team Champions in action. They are, of course, the Minnesota Wrecking Crew, Ole and Gene Anderson. So let's join this match in progress.
Once they've made their tag, neither Anderson releases the opponent until one of the other brothers is in the ring with him. I've noticed also that Ole Anderson seems to be doing more of the talking now he's been reunited with his elder brother.
The tag to Gene. Gene in now with a stomp right across the chest of Davis. And Gene's going to go right back to the arm again. Hard to the corner and into that turnbuckle on that arm and that shoulder. That's a very punishing move, Lord Hayes.
Oh, really? It's the one they have perfected. It has been successful for them. It will be successful for them.
Oh, he made it.
Oh, he was so lucky to escape. Before Russo has a chance, Ole Anderson has got him. And once again, they're going for their particular favorite hold, looking and searching for that left arm every time and the left shoulder. There you are, you see. Neither brother will release an opponent until the other brother is in the ring, ready to take over.
The arm behind, and there's the slam, right down on the arm. Hard, smashing slam, a power slam on the arm as it was behind Russo. And they're staying right with the arm now.
Driving that knee into the arm and shoulder. A nice move there by Ole Anderson. Oh, and the power of that must be tremendous. Watch him hold this until his brother's in.
On the shoulder again, on that left shoulder, hard to the turnbuckle. Right back to the attack into the knee.
Uh-oh.
Here is Ole on the top rope in the corner. All of his weight high into the air, off of the rope, right down across the arm of Russo.
The impact was just unbelievable, and Russo is hardly able to lift himself from the canvas.
This could be it right here. Russo just may not be able to stand
there. Ole urging his brother on, pull his arm, he said, pull and break that arm.
And that is it. Russo, nothing Russo could do at that moment, Lord Hayes.
Absolutely nothing, and once again we've seen how awesome the Anderson brothers can be, how deadly they can be, but also, we must admit it, how exciting they can be. A marvelous win for those two brothers from Minnesota, Gene and Ole Anderson.
Tomorrow night, of course, is the night, the most critical night of wrestling for the contestants in a one-night round-robin tournament for the Georgia Heavyweight Championship. We certainly hope that all of you will make your plans to attend the Omni tomorrow night. Now, the sports arena is open until 9 p.m. tonight to take your reservations. Tickets are currently on sale at all seats locations, the Omni and the sports arena. Remember, tomorrow night you'll be seeing such stars in action at the Omni as the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes, Tommy Wildfire Rich, Wrestling 2, Ted DiBiase and the Freebirds and the Junkyard Dog, and many, many more. That's tomorrow night, 8 o'clock at the Omni. And that's all the time we have for Georgia Championship Wrestling this week. We certainly hope that you'll join us again next week. Remember, we'll be on the air from 5:30 until 7:30. Ernie the Cat Lad will be returning. Ken Patera back with Feats of Strength and many more. Till then, Gordon Solie saying so long.
Thanks for watching Georgia Championship Wrestling. The announcers on this program are employed by Georgia Championship Wrestling, Incorporated. Join us again next week for Georgia Championship Wrestling.